الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله حضرت سیدنا امام صحابی رحمت اللہ علیہ کوٹس that the messenger of Allah عز و جل و صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وآلہ وسلم says that whomsoever sends درود شریف meaning peace and blessings unto me once Allah عز و جل sends 10 times mercy upon him and whomsoever sends 10 times درود شریف upon me Allah Azza wa Jal sends 100 times mercy upon him. And whomsoever sends 100 times peace and blessings unto me, Allah Azza wa Jal will write in between his two eyes that this person is free from nifaq, meaning hypocrisy, and the fire of hell. And on the day of judgment, he will be amongst the shaheeds. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A child got up in the middle of the night and started to cry loudly. When his father heard the child crying, he also got up and asked, "Oh my son, why are you crying?" The child answered, "Dear father, it is Thursday tomorrow, and the teacher will test me for the entire week's lesson. I haven't learned my lesson because of not concentrating in class. And because of this, I will get punished for it tomorrow." After listening to his son, the father's eyes filled with tears. He thought to himself that this child has to answer for a week's lesson, whilst the teacher can be deceived as well. And he can't sleep because of this. And there is me, who has to answer to Allah Azza wa Jal for the whole of my life. And he, Allah Azza wa Jal, can never be deceived. And I have to face up to the test of the day of judgment. But I am sleeping in negligence. Why don't I have any fear? My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madni Channel, just think for a moment how the father brought this thought up into his mind of the hereafter. The child is thinking of the exam of this world, and the father is thinking of the exam of the hereafter. My dear Islamic brothers, think for a moment. When was it the last time we sat down and started to think of the hereafter? Started to think of the examination of the day of judgment? Started to think what would happen to us in the grave? How will we answer the questions of Munkar Nakir in the grave? And then, how will we spend that long period in the dark grave all on our own? And then of the day of judgment, how will we stand barefooted on the ground which is made out of copper? The sun being a quarter of a mile, how will we able to stand on that day? How will we give account of our each and every action of ours on that day. Have you ever thought of this, my dear Islam brothers? We think of everything else. We ponder upon everything else. It starts from childhood. A child starts to think of different things. He starts to ponder upon different things. He starts to think of having this or having that. And when that child, as he gets older, he starts to think of his school life, of his exams at school, about his test at school. And then after that, he starts to think of what subject he's going to choose and how he's going to sit the exams, how he's going to prepare for the exams. And then he starts to think about his degree. And then a person starts to think of how he's going to live his life in comfortable way, about his house, his car, and then about his marriage, and then about his children, and then the marriage of his children. And like this, it goes on and on. We start to think of different things like this, and our life passes. But my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, have we ever thought or pondered upon our deen? Pondered upon how we are living our lives in this world? How much good deeds have we done? And how much sins are we committing every day? Have we ever thought of this? Have we ever pondered about this? That what we are doing our good deeds for? Is it for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal? Or to show people? Have you ever thought about these things? Have you ever thought that how we are going to bring up our children, about teaching them about deen? Have you ever pondered upon these things? And have you ever pondered upon what is going to happen at the time of death? When our soul is going to be taken out? Have you ever pondered when we're going to be lying and someone is going to be washing our body? Have you ever pondered that someone is going to be carrying us in a coffin? They're going to put us into this box. They're going to carry us and they're going to take us to the graveyard. And they're going to put us into the grave, into the dark grave, into this narrow grave. And then they will start to put the earth onto our coffin. They will start to put the soil onto our coffin. And then when they will stop putting the soil, they might shed one or two tears. Stand there for about 5 or 10 minutes. Make dua, make supplication. And then walk away. And at that time, we will only hear footsteps walking away of our loved ones, of our most dearest ones, of our brothers, our sisters, of our best friends. They will leave us. No one will even spend a night beside our grave. Have you ever thought about this? Have you ever pondered about this? My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, this is the thought which Dawat Islami gives us. And this thinking, to think like this, to ponder like this, in the environment of Dawat Islami is called Fikr-e-Madina. Meaning, to ponder upon one's actions, to ponder upon one's deeds, upon one's sins, upon death, upon the hereafter, upon the day of judgment. This, in the environment of Dawat Islam, is called Fikr-e Madina. And my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, this is what Amir-e Ahl-e-Sunnat has given us to do. Amir-e Ahl-e-Sunnat has given us the 72 Madani Anamat, so that we can start to ponder upon our actions. This is the booklet of the 72 Madani Anamat. Shaykh Tariqat Amir-e Ahl-e-Sunnat has given us this so that we start to ponder upon our actions. And my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, this has been the way of the pious people, that they would ponder upon each and every action of this. As Hazrat Imam Muhammad Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi quotes, that Hazrat Ibrahim Tini rahmatullah alayhi, talking about their Fikr-e Madina, talking about their pondering upon the hereafter, says that one day I thought that I am in paradise. I am eating the fruits and drinking from the rivers of paradise and meeting with the who's of paradise. After this, I thought that I am in hell. Just try to understand for a short moment, my dear Islamic brothers. Just try to think for a minute that when the pious people, rahimahumullah, would ponder, think of paradise, they would take this thought out of their mind about paradise and straight away bring the thought of the hell and the fire of hell into their mind. So Hazrat Ibrahim Tini rahmatullah alayh, after thinking of paradise, they bought the thought of the fire of hell. They brought the thought of hell into their mind, and they said that I thought that I am wrapped in the chains of fire, eating the thorns of the trees of hell and drinking from the fluid of the wounds of the people of hell. And after thinking this, I thought to myself, asking my ego, what do you want? Paradise or hell? My ego spoke up, saying paradise. Then they said, saying to myself, that whatever you wish will be granted. But at the moment you are in this world, neither have you entered paradise nor have you gone to hell. And wherever you wish to go, to find the way yourself by doing the actions for it. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, try to understand that how our great ancestors, rahimahumullah, used to examine the ego and keep it in control. In other words, tell themselves off, or even sometimes punish themselves. And these people at all times feared Allah Azawajal and prepared themselves for the hereafter. And because of the effort, they were successful. Allah Azawajal says in the Holy Quran, in the Surah Al-Bani Israel, Para 15, Ayat number 19, verse number 19. And who desires the hereafter and strives for it with necessary effort, and he is a believer, then they are the ones whose striving shall succeed. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, those who strive for the hereafter and he is a believer, then his striving shall definitely reach success. But sadly, our state is such that instead of striving for the hereafter, we are striving for this world. And for this world, we are gathering together all sorts of comforts. We are working for this world only. We are making big bank balances, increasing our businesses, making so much plans for the future. Our whole interest is upon this life, that somehow or another our future is made comfortable and better for us. But sadly, our real life. In other words, the life of the hereafter we have forgotten. And to prepare ourselves for the hereafter, we have done nothing. In fact, people who are busy in gaining success in this world are haunted down by death. Who knows that how much people who are busy in gaining success in this world have reached that dark grave in which they are regretting. Many people might have made plans that I am going to study. I'm going to study hard. And they will sit the examination. They might have even done the exams. But they were not alive to see the results. And examples like this have happened in front of our eyes. Youth are dying. People die at a young age. Find people dying at the age of 5, at the age of 10, at the age of 12, at the age of 15, 18. People who might have been waiting for their graduation, and the angel of death has come and taken the soul. People might have been waiting to get married, but they could not reach that step, and death came to them. Many examples like this are in front of our eyes. We see examples like this day in, day out. People, they might have bought a house, decorated it, and could not live to enter that house. And examples like this are in front of us also. A brother mentioned about another brother who bought a house, and he decorated the house like we do today. We spend thousands of pounds just on decorating a house, building extensions, but none of us have ever thought about the extension of the grave. Mentioning about this brother, that he bought this house, spent money on top of it, decorating it, and few days before he was going to move into the house, he died. Death came to him. The angel of death did not wait till he moved into the house, till he lived a luxury life. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni channel, this is the reality of life, that we do not know when death will come to us. And my dear Islam brothers, he is a great loser who is only working to make this world, who is only working to make this world a better place for himself, who is lost in the thoughts of this world, and he who is busy in working just for this world and forgetting the hereafter. And indeed, the intelligent is he who puts the account of the hereafter in front of him and examines his ego and regrets for his sins, feeling Allah and his punishment. Likewise, it has been the ways of the pious people, rahimahullah. Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Muhammad Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi copies that Hazrat Ibn Samah, once doing fikr Madina, once pondering upon his life, calculated his age, and it came up to around about 60 years. Then he timed 60 with 12, and it came up to about 720. And then timed 720 with 30, and the answer came to 21,600. Like this, the days of his life was 21,600 days. Then, relying on himself, he started to say, if every day I have done one sin. I have committed one sin. Up to now, I would have committed 21,600 sins. And in this life, there must be days in which I would have sinned at least up to 1,000 times. When this thought came into his mind, his heart filled with the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, there and then he started to shake, and a loud scream came out of his blessed mouth and disappeared into the air. And fell onto the ground. A loud scream came out of his mouth and disappeared into the air. And then he fell onto the ground. And when the people came running to see what had happened, they found that his soul had left his body. Rahmatullahi. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni Channel, try to think for a moment that how these pious people, rahimahumullah, would examine themselves, how they would calculate their age. Today we are busy in celebrating our birthdays. We are enjoying on occasions like this, celebrating, enjoying our lives. And who knows what we do on these birthdays nowadays. Today, on birthdays, parties are held, music is played, and many other things take place. And this is how we are calculating our age, how we are pondering upon our age, how we are enjoying our birthdays, how we are being happy of our age. But if we really think for a moment, 1 year has passed more of our lives. We have lost another year of our life, and we are celebrating. And maybe that year which has passed, we might have spent that year in sinning. Then why we are celebrating? If we had spent that whole year in doing good actions, in pleasing Allah Azza wa Jal, then we could have at least think of celebrating. But we might have spent that year in sins day and night. But we are happy. We are pleased with ourselves. And my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madni Channel, just try to concentrate that how our ancestors, rahimahumullah, how they would ponder upon themselves, how they would do fikr in Medina, how they used to examine themselves, although they would be busy in doing good deeds at all times. They would still think themselves as the most sinful of people. They would fear Allah Azza wa Jal at all times. Their fear was such that sometimes their souls would leave their bodies. But my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madni Channel, sadly, today our state is such that every day of our life is spent in sin. Ask yourself this question: is that our life spent in sins? Have we been doing good deeds? Have we been getting up for namaz e fajr, or were we sleeping at that time? Have we been reading the rest of our prayers, or were we busy in earning money? Were we busy in university, college? Ask yourself this question. Did we fast in the month of Ramadan? Did we not look at haram? Did we not swear, backbite, lie, hurt other people's feelings? We do all these things and many more, still we do not fear Allah Azza wa Jal. Our ancestors, rahimahullah, stayed up night praying, fasting in abundance, spend their lives doing good deeds, and even then they would think themselves as the worst of people. Their state was that they would not even leave the optional worship. And today we even leave our compulsory worship, those actions which are farz upon us, we even leave them. And the pious people, rahimahumullah, would even ponder upon their childhood, that in childhood did I do something wrong even in my childhood? Although a sin is not written in childhood, but they would even ponder upon that. They would ponder upon each and every breath they would take, that every breath they took, how did they take it? Was it in the pleasure of Allah, or was it in the love of this world? This is how the pious people, rahimahumullah, would examine themselves. This is how they would live their lives. And my dear Islam brothers, how we are living our lives, we need to start pondering upon this. How can we do this? Shaykh Tariqat, Amir al-Sunnat, the founder of Dawat Islami, Hazrat Mawlana Abu Bilal Muhammad Ilyas Attar Qadri, Damat Barakatum al-Aliyah, has given us a very beautiful way, and that is to the 72 Madani Namaz. This booklet, my dear Islam brothers, contains many ways for us to ponder upon our actions. It's written in a form of a questionnaire that we ask ourselves. We ponder upon ourselves. We ask ourselves, today did we perform namaz? This is one point in the Madani Namaz card. Today, did you read your nawafil? Did you read your sunnats? Today, did you reply to the azan? Today, did you say inshaAllah azza wa jal, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal? Did you reply to sneeze? Did you read Surat al-Mulk? Did you read Ayat al-Kursi? Did you read Tasbih al-Fatima? Today, how much did you eat? Today, did you repent it from your sins? And read 2 rakat namaz salat al-Tawbah? Today, did you read an Islamic book written by a Sunni scholar? Today, did you read 3 verses of the Holy Quran with Kanzul Iman Sharif? Today, did you do infradi koshish, individual effort, and inviting someone else? Today, did you give 2 hours for the sake of deen? Today, did you guard your eyes from haram? Did you control your anger? Today, did you avoid asking unnecessary questions? Today, did you do shari parda? Today, did you watch movies? Listen to music? Today, did you respect your parents? Today, did you look into someone's house? These are the sort of questions which are written in these 72 Madani Namaz. And my dear Islam brothers, when we will ponder upon this, when we will ask ourselves this question, when we will start to ask ourselves that, did you do this today? Did you avoid this today? This action of ours will one day or another lead us towards goodness. And this pondering upon one's action, it has been mentioned in narrations that a moment of meditation, a moment of pondering, is better than 60 years of worship. A moment of thinking is better than 60 years of worship. Why? Because that moment can make you change your mind. This is why we come to the Ijtimaz of Dawat Islami. That for a moment, we might hear the bayans of the Muballigh, and our lives might change. And my dear Islam brothers, lives have changed of people. A brother from the UK mentioned about his changing of life, how his life changed, that he mentioned that he was involved in drugs. He was a drug addict. And it went so far that he started to drink alcohol. And he was in such company where they would drink alcohol. And he says that one day a brother invited me to one of the ijtimas of Dawat Islami. And one of my friends also got ready. So I thought, he's going, we will go together. With no intention of becoming pious, with no intention of goodness, he went. He says that he spent most of the time of the ijtima out wandering on the stalls. And as the ijtima was about to finish, as zikr started, he came into the masjid and sat down. As the zikr was taking place, his heart started to change. And when the dua took place, the effect of the dua was such that he says that from that day he repented. He turned away from everything. He turned away from these bad habits. And he came into the environment of Dawat Islami. And he mentions that giving this bayan, that today he has the zimadari, the responsibility of a Madani kafila. My dear Islam brothers, this is the blessing of the mahol of Dawat Islami. Come into the environment of Dawat Islami if you want to change. Come into the environment of Dawat Islami if you want to learn how to ponder upon your actions. If you want to learn of how to be successful in the grave, how to be successful on the day of judgment, come into the environment of Dawat Islami. And my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni channel, if you really want to change, then Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnat, the founder of Dawat Islami, Hazrat Mawlana Abu Bilal Muhammad Ilyas al-Tahar Qadri Damat Barakatum al-Aliyah, has given us a very beautiful way to change. And that is to travel in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a form of a Madani kafila. My dear Islam brothers, we need to make this intention to travel in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we really want to change. When we will spend 3 days in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we will spend 3 days in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, away from all evil stuff, away from all bad deeds, in good company with the lovers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't you think we will be able to change? So my dear Islam brothers, if you want to change, make an intention. Alhamdulillah, Madani Kafla leave from Leicester also. Give your names forward to the Kafla Zimidar. Make an intention. My dear Islam brothers, we think of everything else, let's start to think about deen. And if you want to really think about our deen, if you really want to ponder upon our deen, then we need to give time for deen. And 3 days, my dear Islam brothers, these 3 days, you will benefit a lot. And brothers have said that I have learned what I learned with 3 days in a Madani kafila of Dawat Islami, I have not learned in my 30 years of life. And this is a fact, my dear Islam brothers. Travel in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Madani kafila and see what you will learn. And also, my dear Islam brothers, if you want to build this thought of pondering upon the hereafter, then my dear Islam brothers, watch Madani channel. Sky 838. Madani channel is changing the lives of millions, changing the lives of thousands. People are changing, people are coming towards deen by just watching Madani channel. There is no advertisement, there is no women on Madani channel. It is purely for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. So my dear Islam brothers, if you have not watched Madani channel up to now, make an intention. I'm going to tune into Madani channel, Sky 838. And inshallah Azza wa Jal, we will be able to ponder upon our actions. We will be able to change ourselves. And inshallah, when we will sit our children with us to watch Madani channel, their mind will change also. they will start to ponder upon the hereafter also. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us all the ability to ponder upon our actions, to worry about our grave, to worry about our hereafter. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect our iman and give us death in the state of iman in the city of Medina. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ